Camp cooking. Here we are. We're working on Crispy's Camp Nori here. We got some dehydrated, sun-dried tomatoes that I'm cutting on that have been soaking in Gila water all afternoon. Dicing these up for part one of our food prep for dinner tonight, which is going to be Camp Nori. So stay tuned.
The NMD crew has been adventuring in the Gila wilderness for 16 miles in 3 days, and we're currently relaxing in a sandy alcove. With plenty of wood to feed our cooking fire, our attention turns to feeding ourselves. Everything tastes better in the wild, including sushi rolls, or as we like to call it, Camp Nori.
Here we go, sushi rice. Campfire style. We're calling it smoky flavored sushi rice. Sweet rice.
Okay, so this is great. We've arrived at our second night's camp and we have a beautiful alcove to sleep in tonight. Take a look at that right behind me. That is a nice place to sleep. Room for four. We're not gonna need to put up any tents or anything. We'll have a nice fire burning. Plus, we're right on the river here. Take a look at this.
Little wasabi going on here. Got some wasabi powder and I'm just gonna add some Gila water to that and we're gonna dip it in our sushi later on in the wasabi, and we've got soy sauce packets. We are gonna tear it up tonight. We're gonna be rolling some sushi, some nori here pretty soon, so stay tuned.
The Abert squirrel is a common tree squirrel of the Gila wilderness. Look for them in ponderosa pine forest.
There you go, sit right on that. Dude, even that's pretty hot.
Yeah, it seems too hot. I think it's already cooked up in the past. Here we are, the Gila Wilderness, Camp Nori. We've got sushi rice cooked on the fire with a little sugar and a little vinegar added. Came out nice and sticky, which is what we were looking for. Got it cooled down enough that it's easy to work with here. And this is it.
This right here is a really good example of what you can't take from the wilderness. These are Rocky Mountain elk antlers, and they're attached to the skull cap. Elk shed their antlers each year, so it's legal to take the sheds, but you need a tag or permit to own the skull. If you find a skull and you want to keep it, contact your local game and fish warden.
Nice rack! Okay, so here we have my vegetables. I got a couple of cooked carrots, sun-dried tomatoes, some avocado already sliced up, ready to go, some packet canned smoked Alaskan wild salmon. I've got my nori sheet, and I'm putting the rice on the nori sheet. Kind of thick. Now it's time to get really creative. We're gonna take a little bit of here. A bada bing. Bada boom. Sun-dried tomato. Nice and chopped up. Nice and easily cut. Fresh avocado. And salmon. Normally I like to have a little pickled ginger available, but we're roughing it this time, so hopefully this will be adequate enough. You can use tuna packet too if you really like. This is our backup plan because we didn't catch any trout tonight. So, okay, I think we got everything. We're a little limited on soy sauce packets, but I do have, if we look under here, keeping the dust free, some soy sauce and wasabi powder mixed up to paste. We're gonna dip our little sushi roll in there. Now we are ready to attempt to roll. I haven't done this in a while, so bear with me. We call it Camp Nori. I like to give it a little extra just to make sure we're nice and tight there. I'm just gonna pack in the edges here a little bit before we get the zoom off of it. So I really do like to make sure that this stays nice and tight. Okay, now we're ready to serve it up.
Having a really sharp knife helps.
Okay, who's hungry? Because I got a little something to show you. Call it Camp Nori.
Spent two nights here at Hell's Hole in this sweet little alcove, just sort of recovering, taking a break, recharging a little bit. We're gonna do one river crossing this morning and then head out of the canyon. Got about a 1,200 foot climb ahead of us. And about a 3 mile gentle rolling walk to a prior cabin up on the top part here. But yeah, I feel surprisingly good. Up before the sun hit camp this morning, charged on breakfast, had a little fire and some coffee, and I think we're ready to go.